Part 1. The Hole in Clay. The most merciful thing in the world again is the inability of the human mind to correlate all of its contents. We live in a placid island of ignorance in the midst of black seas of infinity. And it was not meant that you voyage far. The sciences, each straining in its own description, have his hero, Hamil, or statue. But someday the piecing together of disassociated knowledge will open up through the refined vista of reality, and over frightful pursuit therein, that we shall either go mad from the revelation or flee from the light into the breeze and safety of the new dark age. Your ships have geese and the ocean grandeur of the cosmic circle, whenever the world and human race form dancing incidents. They have hinted the strange revivals in terms which will freeze the world if not masked by a blind optimism. But it is not from them that there came the simple gleam of the forbidden neons, which chills me when I think of it and maddens me when I dream of it. That glimpse, like all great glimpses of two, flashes out from an accidental piecing together of separated things. In the cave from all newspaper eating and no one for you. I hope that no one else will accompany the piecing out. Certainly, if I live, I shall never knowledge to apply a link in so he you say. I think that professor too intended to keep silent the guardian the path he knew, and that he would have destroyed his notes had not soon death seen him. My knowledge of the thing began in the winter of 1926 or 27 with the tale of the growing uncle. George Gamil, Anger, Professor Emeritus of Semitic Languages in Bonn University, Providence, Rhode Island, Professor Anger was widely known as an authority on ancient inscriptions and had frequently been resorted to by the heads of prominent museums, so that his passing at the age of 92 may be recalled by many. Locally, interest was intensified by the obscurity of the cause of death. The professor had his striking wizard returning from the Upepe Bowl. Falling suddenly, as witnesses said, after having been drawn by a nautical looking negro who had come from one of the weird dark coast of the prodigious hillside, which formed a short cut from the waterfront to the deceased home in William Street. Physicians were unable to find any visible disorder, but concluded that the perplexed debate that some obscure region of the heart induced by the big sexing of a ship appeared by solidly a man was responsible for the end. At the time, I was no reason for knowledge to descend from this discord, but later I have included the warning, and more than warning. As my great uncle healed and executed for the day as a child would wear, I was expected to go over his pipes with some thoroughness, and for that purpose, moving his entire set of files and boxes to my cottage in Boston. Most of the material which I collected will be later published by the American Archaeology Society, but there was one box which I found exceedingly puzzling, and which I felt much averse from showing to repeat eyes. It had been looking and he did not find the key. They concluded to me Donc, ça mine des personnes en ligne, oui, des professions créées ici pour qu'elles tiennent une ligne à ce qui est une opinion. Et, pour tout point d'arrêter, sauf si mes dons et tous les confondus n'ont pas la qualité à mon cours, comme ils ont qu'ils prennent. Faut voir la courbe, et bien, on va découvrir que les bases fidélistes ont des difficultés de login. Rambling and clicks, which I found, have many ongoing related become credos of the most superficial impulses. I was ready to teach how the syntax could be possible for the apparent disturbance of an old man's peace of mind. The past is river was a dog, jungle, and an easy, and about five by six inches in area. A few years of modern origin, it is science, however, we found for modern, in atmosphere and suggestion. For the variety of vision and futurism and many a while, they do not know the production activity that you relate with toxic pistol writing. And writing of some kind of book of those designs seems to be dog with memory. Despite more the paper and collection of the unconfident in any defining a particular species, or even here in the museum of affiliations. About these apparent hieroglyphs, what a figure of heavy and pictorial intention is in Pisoni's execution for play a very clear idea of his nature. It seemed to be sort of a monster, or symbol representing a monster, of a form which only this fancy could conceive. If I say that somehow extravagant imagination deals with the mutant species of an octopus and a dragon, and a human caricature, I cannot be unfaithful to the spirit of the day. A poppy tentacle is a bondage, a rotation in sky boy which remained wings by what general outline of the wolf we made more shockingly frightful. Behind the figure was a big suggestion of a cyclopean architectural background. The writing accompanying this boy was designed from a stack of pre-schooling and professionalism was in his hand. I made no purchases to an eager extent, but seemed to be the main document was a good to go. In charge of this prince, taking a print to avoid the royal reading of a war store or held off. This month he was divided into two sections. The fish of which was held in 1925, during and during War of Ages, we could save it with domestication provided RIA, and the second narrative with respect to John R. the Great, 121 being built here, New Orleans, LA, and 1908. AAS make notion same and proof of whips acts. The old manuscript paper was brief. Notion came a claim from the quest dreams of river and prison. Some of the citation from theosophical books and magazines. Notably, W. is called Helios Atlantis and Helios Lemuria. And great comments on non surviving secret societies and great cause. With reference to present in such mythological and anthropological sources, books as such as world involving these movies which clearly question Europe, the cutting lazily a lot of tormental ended an outbreak of good folly of mine here and in spring of 1925. The first half of the visible manuscript took a very particular day. Ihr bist der Omaisfisch 1925 als jeden Tag Young Man of New Jersey and excited to speak. Hat gerade upon Professor Angel Billing the singular clay pass relief. We watched him exceedingly dumb and fresh. His car bore the name of Henry Anthony Wilcox. My uncle had recognized him as the youngest son of an excellent family is already known to him, who had lately been destroyed in a sculpture of the old Israel School of Design and living alone on the freeway to East building near that institution. Wilcox was the precocious girl of known genius, but great eccentricity, and had from childhood desired attention to the strange stories and odd dreams he was in the habit of relating. He called himself physically hypersensitive, but the state folk of the ancient commercial city dismissed him as merely queer, never mingling much with his kind. He had dropped gradually from social visibility and was now known only to a small group of Easties from northern towns. Even the Providence Art Club, anxious to preserve its conservatism, has found him quite hopeless on the occasion of the visit. On the occasion of the visit of the professor's manuscript, the sculptor abruptly asked for the benefit of his whole archaeological knowledge in identifying the hieroglyphs at the bas relief. He spoke in dreamy, silly manner which suggested both an alienating sympathy, and his uncle showed some calmness in replying for the conspicuous freshness of the traveling implied kinship with the anything but archaeologic. John Wilcox rejoined, which impressed my uncle enough to make him recur on the color it brought him, was of a fantastically poetic cast which must have typified his whole exhibition and which I have since found highly characteristic of him. He said, "It is you indeed, but maybe the last night in a dream of strange cities and dreams are older than boring tire of the contemplating Sphinx or Garden Gilbert Babylon." God. Oh, this is hard in my throat. It was then that he began the drumming in tale which would impress upon a sleeping memory and wound the vivid interest of my uncle. There had been a slight earthquake tremor the night before, the most considerable felt in New England for some years, and Wilcox's imagination had been keenly affected. Upon retiring, he had an unprecedented dream of great Cyclopean city of Titan blocks inscribed through monoliths, all dripping with green ooze and seized with the writing hole. Hieroglyphics had covered the walls and pillars, and from some of the immediate point below had come voice that was not a voice, a chaotic sensation which only fancy could transmute into sound, but which he attempted to render by the almost unpronounceable jumble of letters Cthulhu if tongue. His verbal jumble was the key to the collection which existed on the Sophie Professor Ranger. He questioned the sculpture which is achieving my mutinies and instructed with frantic intensity the box release on which the joke had found himself walking, chilling and clad only with his night clothes. When walking, her stunning bewitchery over him, my uncle blaming his old age, which was afterwards said for his knowingness, in recognition both hieroglyphics and pictorial designs. Many of these questions seem highly out of place to individuals, especially those which try to connect the letters with the strange codes of society. And we could not understand the repeated promises of science which he was offered in exchange for an admission of membership shown widespread mystical or barely religious body. When Professor Angel became convinced that the sculpture was indeed none of any conception of creepy law, he received his visit with demand of field reports of dreams. This bore regular fruit, for after the first interview, the manuscript records daily accounts of the young man doing which he related starting fragments of natural imagery, whose body was always some terrible scorpion piece of dark and sleeping stone, with a strong voice of intelligence shouting monotonous and enigmatic sense impact on his scribbles gave a gibberish. The two sounds frequently repeated, and those rendered by the letters Cthulhu and Lael. On March 23, the manuscript continued. We could finish to appear, and inquired at the Scottish reader that he had been sleeping with an obscure sort of fever and taken to the home of his family in Waterman Street. He had cried out in the night, arousing several other artists in the building, and had manifested such genuine only alterations of consciousness and delirium. My uncle one day telephoned the family, and from that time forward kept close watch of the case, calling often at the Trial Street office Dr. Toby, from he learned to be in charge. The judge's frivolous mind apparently was dwelling on strange things, and the doctor chortled now and then as he spoke of them. They increased not only the repetition of what he had informed me in dreaming, but to see wildly on the gigantic things, miles high, which walked or lumbered about.
God damn it, this is not good for my troll. Okay, another one.
He had no time fully described this object, but occasionally found his words. As repeated by Dr. Tobey, convinced the professor that it must be identical with the nameless monstrosity he had sought to depict in his dream sculpture. Reference to his object, the doctor added, was invaluable, a prelude to the young man's seriousness into lethargy. His temperature, oddly enough, was not greatly above normal, but the whole condition was otherwise such as those suggested to fever worse than mental disorder.
On April 2, at about 3 p.m., every trace of Wilcox's malady suddenly ceased. He started lying in bed, astonished to find himself at home and completely ignorant of what had happened in the dream of realities on his night of March 22. Pronounced well by his physician, he returned to his quarters in 3 days, but to Professor Angel, he was of no further assistance. All traces of his strange dreaming had vanished with his recovery, and my uncle kept no records of his night dose after a week of pointless and irrelevant accounts of truly unusual visions. Here, the fifth part of the manuscript ended, but reference to certain of the scattered notes gave me such material for doubt. so much. In fact, the only the ingredient skepticism then forming my philosophy can account for my continued distrust of justice. The note in question were those descriptive of the dream of various species covering the same period as the linguist John Wilkes had his strange visitations. My uncle, it seems, had quickly instituted a procedurally far from body of inquiries on nearly all the friends whom he could question without impertinency, asking for nearly the both of their dreams and the days of any notable visions for those times past. The reception of his request seems to have varied, but he must, at the very least, have received more responses than any ordinary man who have handled a secretary. The original correspondence was not present, but his notes forming a truthful, though really significant, yes. Obvious people in society and business, New English traditional south of L gave an almost completely negative result, though scattered cases of uneasy but formless nocturnal impression appeared here and there, always between March 23 and April 2, the pair of John Wilkes delirium. Scientific men were real more affected, though for cases of vague descriptions suggested fully waves of strange landscapes, and in one case there is mentioned a dread of something abnormal.
This is the hell of my throat.
Oh. It was from the artist and poet that the pertinent announcement came and knew that panic would have broken loose had they been all able to compare notes. As it was lacking the original series, I have suspected the compiler of having asked reading questions or of having edited the correspondence in collaboration of what he had really resolved to see. That is why I continue to feel the way Cooks somehow cognition of the old data which my uncle had possessed has been imposing on those bitter anxieties. These responses from essays totally sober sale. From February 28 to April 2, a large portion of them had dreamed very bizarre things. The intensity of the dreams being immensurably stronger during the period of scriptural delirium. Over a fourth of those who reported anything reporting since, and half sounds not in like those which Wilkes have described, and some of the dreamers confess a curious fear of the gigantic neighbor is invisible to us. One case which no describes with emphasis was very sad. The subject really young architect with any duality of sophy and occultism when violently insane on the edge of John Wilkes' issue. An expired several months later, after his son screaming to be saved from some escape the nation of hell. Had my uncle referred to this case by name instead of mentioning my number, I should have attempted some corroboration on visual investigation. But as he was, I succeeded in tracing down only a few. All of those, however, bore out the notes in full. I have often wondered if all these objects of the professor's questioning fail as possible as this distraction. It is well that no explanation shall ever reach them.
Only the paragraph.
The police coatings as a half in the immediate dosing of cases of panic, mania, and eccentricity during the given period. Professor Hanje Moore have employed a coaching program for the number of strikes was tremendous, and the sources cutting to the globe. He was an autonomous suicide in London, where a lone sleeper had slipped from a window of the shocking crime. Here, life was a lambing way to a little of a pipe in South America, where a fanatic delusion of dying future from vision he was seen. A Spanish from California is quite a theosophy's colony, I don't know why robes and maids for some glorious fulfillment which never arrives, with James from India speak. What is your fear of nothing arrested towards the end of March 22 to 23?
Last bit. Last bit. Come on, you can do it.
The west of Ireland, too, is full of wild rumors and legendary. And a fantastic painter named Andrew Bonnot hangs of the famous dream landscape in the Paris Spring Salon of 1926. And so numerous are the records troubles in insane and general that only a miracle can have stopped the miracle of eternity from nothing, his strange parallelism and driving his mystified conclusions. A wee board of coatings, although an icon at this taste. It's clearly in business the colonial situationism, which I set them aside, but I was then convinced that John Wilkes had known of the old manners mentioned by the professor.
And I'm done. Bye.